Hey guys, what's up? Today we are going to learn how to create 3D isometric logo in Illustrator. If you are new here, then please subscribe to our channel to get updates on every tutorial. You can apply this effect on any vector logo, and this can be used to create mock-up or 3D display or a wallpaper of your logo. So let's start. First, create new file and set dimension to 1600 by 1200 pixel or any dimension values you want and hit create. In new document, select rectangle and click to left corner of artboard and set same dimensions for background. We don't want white color for background, so double click on fill color and change it to light gray. Now lock background layer and create new one. Now draw one more rectangle which will be the base for our logo. Align it to center of artboard. Select these points and drag inside to set roundness. And change fill color to white. Now go to effect and 3D materials. We have two 3D effects. One is classic and another is new 3D effect. If you apply new extrude effect and isometric top, and if you try to separate depth using expand appearance, then it will convert that object into raster, which we don't want. So let's undo this and apply 3D classic effect. And now expand appearance and press Ctrl Y for outline mode. Click right mouse button and select ungroup for 2 times. And hold shift and click base to deselect. Now select unite to merge them and again press Ctrl Y to go back to normal mode. Change depth color base color to white . Hold alt plus drag to create copy and change color . Press Ctrl left bracket to send it to back. To make it soft, go to Effect and Blur and select Gaussian Blur. Now our base is ready. Now copy and paste your logo. It must be vector. Now go to 3D material. Select new extrude and bevel. And change preset to isometric top. You can also check different isometric presets. But for this tutorial, we are going to select top. You can change angle to 90. Now it's time to apply some light effect. You can try with some default presets and play with some settings. Click on Render with Ray Tracing for final result. Let's add some shadow to make it more realistic. Now our isometric logo is ready. Okay then, try this on your logo and share me what you have done. Thanks for watching and subscribe for new videos.